not the man behind the yodeling is Devin 3000, which leaves one culprit.
not the middle fingers.
You're the one who makes it so you can't.
Oh no!
I guess if you run the stream, you can break the stream zone rules. But
I don't know. But we're already seeing a little bit of good neutral from player four, just being very defensive and trying
68.
To put on some damage.
You
just don't know
like,
about Peach?
Oh, I know. I'm just saying.
You gotta let the girls, the gays, the days, and the he's know about Peach.
Yes, I think player four is doing that right now. 98%, and this is kill percent now. Oh, we're trying to get some cheese. That is one thing. Peaches do tend to get cheesed a lot. Really light for the character. Easy to land some pretty janky stuff.
Absolutely, and very nice tuck right there. Trying to control a lot of the stage. However, down smash. Just a little bit too late on the down smash. Didn't want to really get hit with an up air or up B in that moment. Very nice on, you know, player four's part, but we're trying to get back to center stage pretty comfortably, and Devin is keeping it pretty even.
After getting, you know, pretty much like 0 to 100, brought back now to where they're both at kill percents and a good aggressive option.
Okay. Very nice. Played at that. Ooh, and the booty bump, the Peach. The backer is absolutely going to take it. The booty bump again will end that stock. And are we going to see?
Good patience for player four right there. That is one thing that I believe is like a bit of a habit of Devin 3000. He loves to land aggressive. With Charizard, he loves the Nair. With Ivysaur, he loves that landing fair. And that is something that can be called out. You know, there are good options, but every good option can get red. And 88%, it almost seems like you just have to start your stock taking like at least 70 versus Peach.
Absolutely, and I just have to mention this, I always love talking about this when we actually talk about Peach players. Player four is probably one of my favorite Peach players just because of how defensive he is. Literally probably one of the best defensive Peaches that I ever like see. But you know, aside from Ling Ling, we definitely love Ling Ling and the other Peaches that we do have. I just love the defensiveness. It's probably one of my favorite things about just playing, especially with Peach. Peach is definitely, if you've never played Peach, you would never know how hard it is to actually play her because her disadvantages can be super bad sometimes, super scary. And yeah, that's just how that kind of is for Peach.
Yeah, and adding on to that, as you were saying, player four really defensive. Definitely looks true. One of those, you know, Peach has all these movement options, but player four loves to just kind of stand still sometimes. You know, you don't need to always be doing something. So player four gets a lot of percent by standing still, waiting for you to do something, then using Peach's really good movement to whiff punish, rather than just always trying to move around.
Absolutely.
And look at that right there. Going back, back airing it. And now this is really scary.
Ooh, very nice switch, good in time, but that fair is gonna do it, jumping for the ledge, not taking it just entirely yet, but we could see another fair. Is the back throw gonna do it? Probably not. Back throw did get nerfed a while ago. A little bit more than a while ago, almost maybe a year?
More than a year ago. It was definitely pre-COVID. It's an old nerf. I think at least. Maybe I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure that's like one of the, it was like the same nerf they nerfed the fair. It was like a really early one.
Absolutely. I remember when Peach was like super good. She had to have been top tier.
Oh, I mean, she still is like to people. I mean, it's definitely more of a debate how high she is now. But yeah, there was people were putting Peach in top one in some cases, early ultimate. But definitely still a really strong pick. Very early.
I know that sounds weird. I'm not. I still play Peach on the side. Just never really play her. But I don't know. Maybe I'm a fan. Who knows?
No, she's fun. It's such a commitment to get her inputs down, you know? Like, you have to.
You know
feel
what
like
the real commitment is?
Lead.
You know what the real commitment is? Learning how to play disadvantages. Her disadvantage. I've talked about it already. It is super bad. You get lush trapped for almost half the game if you don't know how to, like, really, really mix up your disadvantage.
Yeah, but like, that being said, pretty much every Peach main at this point is so dedicated to this character. You know, they don't just casually play Peach. They really try to lab what to do for every situation.
You're attacking me. Wait,
no,
hold on.
I said Peach main. You're a Bayo main. The Bayo connoisseur.
Oh, yes, period. You can't forget about that, period. But yeah, we're definitely seeing a very almost even game. 88 to 53. 59, actually. I'm sorry. and some very nice neutral going on. I definitely love the way that both of these players are actually really interacting with each other. Very nice down throw to Nair, and we are not going to see that fair. That was very close. Not going to take it yet, and that back throw almost killing. This is a little bit scary. Player 4, you got to be very careful. I don't know.
Player 4 opting to go really high right there to avoid all the Ivy, like Nair spam. Whereas we've been seeing Dem3000 pretty much opt almost solo Ivy this matchup, and I think it's because of how well Ivy can cover the airspace Peach likes to float in. But losing the first stock, and we saw this last game where they were both at high percents, but then player 4 just got a crazy combo and kind of ran away with the rest of the game. So can Devin stop that?
Ooh, that was such a good call out. They were trying to read the switch right there, but not gonna get it. Still at 162%, and they have to be very careful because anything will actually kill Peach right now. She's definitely a lighty, and that with grab is going to do it. I feel like maybe player 4 should be going for a little bit more dash attacks, especially since they have been reading a lot of those switches. Those switches are definitely more important. That's actually one of the very, you know, good things about actually playing this matchup. You have to really know how to read a lot of switches from PT. If you don't know how to do that, you can definitely be struggling pretty hard because you miss out on a lot of kill opportunities and a lot of damage opportunities when you actually have people in disadvantage.
Right here, 108% and counting, not been able to get back on ledge. And look at that beautiful landing, landing and then grabbing in the other direction. And Dem3000 has done multiple air dodges on the stage right now. And player 4 is just ready to dash back and punch it, landing aggressively. That was such an insanely clean stock from player 4. Just pretty much played perfect the entire time, not getting hit and keeping Dem3000 at ledge. And now this is really rough. You're gonna need some really good Ivy strings going. And player 4 is DI'ing the up to land on the other side so you cannot get comboed into Vine Whip.
Absolutely. Okay, not gonna get too much off of that, but that back air is gonna put him into a tech situation. Ooh, what's kind of going on right here? We are still a stock down, and you have to be very careful how recovering. That was very nice getting aggressive off stage there, but not going to really work out too well in Devin's favor. This is scary. Okay, very nice back air. Have a little shot situation. Very nice get up attack right there, and wow, very nice reacting to that grab or that counter right there. Ooh, not gonna do too much, throwing that right back off stage. Down throw, what is that gonna do?
Yeah, this is definitely where Devin's gonna need to like clutch up, because you can't just, if you let, if you let player 4 live this long, he's gonna just find a way to take your stock fully and just totally two stock you, and that's exactly what happened. Just, player 4 just played so clean right there in knowing where Devin was going to be. Oh.
No! He did the whole fireball jutsu hand sign or hand technique, please, into the FU. Literally, I can't even.
As far as I'm concerned, Dem3000 just won the set right there. Beautiful handshake mix up, getting the middle finger, totally outplaying player 4. Great stuff.
Period. Very nice. That game right there. And the little mini game that they had fun with. You know, Mario Superstars. Is that what it's called?
Mario Party.
Mario Party Super. No, because it's the newer game.
Oh,
that we
the
have,
newer
the
one?
Mario
yeah,
Party
I'm not
Superstars,
sure.
I think it
I'm
is.
Not sure.
I mean, if we're going to be talking about Mario Party, we have to be talking about Mario Party 8.
8?
My favorite Mario Party.
Oh,
I don't know.
Wait, we're going to see a really important replay right here. Ooh, goes in to bait out the grab.
Yes. The hand technique.
Moving back and forth into the fade back middle finger.
Mm-hmm.
Beautiful stuff.
Y'all don't know about the secret tea. Y'all don't know about that. Mm-mm. So please, very nice.
No, should we run some ads while we're waiting?
I think it's gonna start like right. We're just putting their names. We could do like one ad, I think, though.
Okay, period. So I wanna let you guys know already. Haven't